Let's now look at layer 7 flow observability with Cilium and Hubble. Now, in the previous video, what we looked at was how we can use Cilium and Hubble to automatically create a flow diagram, right? Looking at things like IP addresses, TCP ports, but also having some kind of awareness of Kubernetes objects. But clearly what you would also like to have, if you can, if possible, is to have more granular visibility into at layer 7, for example, at the HTTP request packets to find out more about HTTP path, status code, or that kind of data. And the way to do it is to use the embedded Envoy proxy that lives with Cilium. We can't kind of do it natively within eBPF, so we have to forward the traffic internally to the Envoy proxy that is running within the Cilium agent. For this, I'm going to be using the Cilium service mesh lab again. Now we have two ways. One is to annotate a pod, and I would add layer 7 visibility to our Hubble flow. Right? You can even see back in the documentations here. As you can see, we can just add some kind of annotation, and it has to follow a specific format. As you can see, the traffic direction, example egress, layer 4 port and protocol, and then the layer 7 protocol. Right? So maybe you want to look for DNS traffic, or maybe you want to look for HTTP traffic. Right? So you can annotate a specific pod, and automatically will generate some, you'll start seeing some visibility for this traffic. Now let's try straight away here. So we're going to annotate here. So we look at how we are applying the label based on this annotation based on the label product page. And we are looking for ingress traffic over port 9080 for TCP and HTTP. Right? So we're being quite granular about the type of traffic we're looking for. If I just now refresh that application, let's see in the Hubble UI, you can see HTTP has just appeared. Right? So we are now sending some visibility into at the HTTP level, right? You can see that there was a GET call to slash product page path. Great. So that's option number one. Then now let's now look at option number two. In option number two, what we are doing is using a network policies. Again, the layer 7 policies, network policies, will result in the traffic being proxied through an Envoy instance, provided in each Cilium agent pod. So we're going to use this example policy, which essentially applies to for TCP traffic over port 80, 8080, 9080, etc. And we'll apply it across the whole cluster. Let's have a look. Again, let's refresh the application. And now we should begin to see more and more data in here. Right, so you can see from product page to reviews, that was a call made over slash review slash zero. Go back again to slash details, and if we use a Hubble CLI. And we start to see more information about exactly the type of call. Now let's be a bit more granular, and that's the beauty of the CLI, especially is how you can add more and more filters. So right now we are looking for traffic over port HTTP, and we are just looking for the traffic that matches the label app equals reviews over port 9080. Again, you can see HTTP 11 get traffic to this specific URL. Then you can look for traffic based on the path, or for example, just slash details, traffic to slash details. Again, you can find it. You can see it comes from the product page to the details pod. You could also, and actually we don't need this. We can just look for, let's say, HTTP status, 200. Again, you see all the 200 requests, 200 searches code replying successfully. And you can just be very granular with how you observe traffic. Again, we can, for example, use the method. So you know, you can filter based on all the GET calls. And you can combine several different flags. For example, if you want to see the GET calls to specific application, again, based on the labels. So we want to see the traffic to the details app, and we'll just change the format. And again, you can see traffic, you can see the timestamp, source destination, the network policy verdict, and the layer 7 filter. So that's the end of the video. Again, you'll see we've got a couple of different ways to gain layer 7 visibility. One was to annotate pod, or one was to apply a layer 7 network policy. But it's, as you can see, it's very powerful. We've only shown examples for HTTP, but it works with, you know, gRPC or Kafka, so different types of layer 7 protocols. Okay, well, thanks for watching. If you like this video, feel free to subscribe, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.